Tiki mai, kake mai,
wakarongo ki te tangi a te hui a hui, hui mai tātou, hiti hiti kōrero piua ki te awe. Hei mātaki taki, hei wakarongo, mā te tini me te mamoe.
Above the song of the sea, there is an unnatural sound. It's the sound of Sai Chen, a Japanese martial art practiced by self-confessed martial arts addict and professional fighter Tony Renata. Each morning as he greets the day, Tony prepares himself to train. It's part of his devotion to what he calls his trade. Even his daughter is named Ishoa, the karate black belt symbol of female enlightenment.
Okay. Bye. Bye.
From one stage to another, I was had a fairly broken up sort of a childhood, and just mixing in with the wrong type of people and gangs and all that type of thing, and sort of one thing led to another. I was into fighting, and that was one of the main trouble spots with my adolescence was the fighting. So I decided to channel it in the right areas and decided to join martial arts and be able to do fighting without getting in trouble or the law getting on my back about it. And from there on, I sort of haven't looked back and just kept on continuously.
In his teens, Tony was very much a casualty of both circumstance and his own rebellious spirit. Brought up in the northern town of Kaio, he was expelled from school at 14, went through borstal, foster homes, and hung out with the Highway 61 gang before deciding at 17 to venture into a gym to try his hand at Budokan karate.
My background is aggressive, but it's controlled aggression. Generally, my personality towards people it wouldn't be aggressive. All depends what type of situation I'm in, you know. If I'm in a business situation, you know, I can control aggression towards business. If I'm in a fight situation in the ring, surely I need that aggression. And when I teach my students martial arts, I also teach them aggression as well, but controlled aggression, yeah.
In the past 10 years, armed with this controlled aggression, Tony has fought his way through the Australasian ranks to take a number of titles. In Australia, he fought in front of hundreds of people, but was never fazed by it.
When I'm in there, I think there's just me and him, and I've never been in much in touch with drugs at all, but it's just like a big boost in the body, you know. You just, all, it's just a natural high in there for me, and the lights, and you know, just being in there, it's just being like a racing car driver, I suppose. It's just that much speed going on, and then half the time you don't know what's going on.
But knowing what's going on can be painful for those who watch.
He gets bleeding noses, and there's often a cut eye, and when, you know, when their eye's cut, their eye blows up, and you end up with a big bruise, so it looks like Rocky, and, you know, then there's the anxiety because, if he gets knocked down, I know that he has the strength to get back up again, so I've got to get in there and let him know that he's all right and to snap out of it and get up and stay strong and use his chi to win.
What's
he's got to win.
What's chi?
Oh, chi is inner strength. Tony has heaps of that. Comes from his napui, I think. So he keeps telling me all the time. That's what makes him win his fights.
Okay. You have that blade of the foot, especially for the psychic, you have that blade of the foot out nice and tight. Okay,
Tony believes the Ngāpuhi warrior spirit is the force that drives him inside the ring, but he's also made some remarkable moves as a tutor.
And shuffle back down, in my time, on the count. Itch. Good. Knee.
Since returning from Australia 4 years ago, he's opened 26 schools of Zendo Kai Karate. Of those pupils, 60% are Māori. Why have you come here to learn martial arts?
Myself? Oh, well, it's not only myself, but my family as well. Bring them here for it's good physical fitness and keeps them looking good, keeps us all looking good.
Mainly for self-defence, you know, if ever I was attacked in the street or, you know, anything like that, then I should be confident enough to be able to, you know, look after myself. And for physical fitness.
Why have you come to learn martial arts?
Because so I can defend myself.
Okay, one. Extend hips out as well.
In recent years, Tony specialised in kickboxing, a sport once called contact karate, with techniques and philosophy from Asia and rules from the United States. Tony hopes the popularity of the sport will grow throughout this country, and one sure way of spreading the word is by organising demonstration and competition fights. He's been working on it, using exclusive venues like Auckland's Hyatt Kingsgate Centre, aiming for a look similar to the overseas gore and glamour fights.
You know how you've got the ringside seats around here? These back areas here, they all... Is it possible to have some people standing up behind there as well?
I think the foyer might be the best, and that way they can sort of all come, eat in a separate place.
There's little doubt that Tony's love of martial arts has spread through his family. Annie, his mate, is herself a black belt, and Tony's brothers and sisters have all gradually become interested. Even Waiponga Napier, who lives with Tony's sister Julianne, is, after only 4 years, ranked as Yakuza.
At the beginning, I didn't get into it for the enjoyment because I got into it more for the self-control.
I joined it mainly because I didn't want to sit at home on my own. And self-defence, and the rest of my family was doing it as well. And it was just mainly being one big family.
Still, that doesn't mean it's always a happy family. The couple worry about the effect on their four-year-old son, Jay.
All he learns has learnt so far is aggression, and learnt how to be violent. He hasn't got the knowledge that we have of how to use it, how to slow it down. He only knows that he's seen karate as fighting and a way to beat people up. You know, he hears different things, but he can't sort of fan out in his brain that it's not really just to beat people up.
Because I didn't know I could talk to people in a way to teach them until I got into karate. And that's what actually helped me talk to people. Training in karate and then Tony put it on me to teach, and once he stuck it on me, I realised that I could do it, and that was it. I just went and done it. Because where I'm teaching at the moment, I've got a lot of Maori students, and they've actually got into it to try and keep them out of the hotels and keep them off drugs and stuff like that, which I think is really good. And I've got a lot of married couples as well with their children that are into it. And they're into it not only for the self-defence, but for the discipline and the fitness. And it just gives them a clearer head, you know?
Another of Tony's ex-students, Marie Scott, was walking along a beach last year when two men tried to attack her.
The guys, they didn't actually come close to me, you know, close enough to me. I didn't know what they were going to do. And one come from behind and one come in front. You know, before they did anything to me, I just warned them that, you know, I do karate. And so they both of them took one look at me and thought, you know, a little thing like you. And so they come in, one came to grab me from behind, so I just gave him one. I just winded him. And the other one came in front and I just gave him a kick.
Marie now teaches self-defence, and she's made sure to pass on her skills to her daughters.
It's given me a lot of confidence in myself. Once upon a time I wasn't able to walk in the dark, by myself. But now I feel as though that I can, look after myself. And it also is giving, my girls confidence in themselves. If they ever had to walk in the dark, they should be able to defend themselves.
As his students have progressed, so Tony has moved through to the fifth degree black belt stage of Zendo Kai, a path which inevitably encompasses weaponry.
The weapons are an extension of the body, so I personally, myself, I don't like teaching weapons to anybody that has no experience with the full use of their body. You've got your two hands and your two feet and your elbows and knees and everything else that's attached to your body. Until you are trained specifically to use them properly, then I think you can extend yourself onto weapons, and they become more natural to you that way, rather than just picking up taiha or sai or katana. I think it'll come naturally to you, You go through stages in martial arts, and it sort of goes with your degrees and your rankings and everything else, So you just, it comes naturally. You treat it as an extension of the body. Māori's still got that very, very spiritual side, as well as the physical side. So I think if you use the two as a good balance, you could say the yin and yin, then you've got a good even flow all the way around.
Is the image portrayed in movies by people like Chuck Norris and Bruce Lee realistic?
It set the path right for all of us guys, yeah. If you're making a living out of it, Bruce Lee, Chuck Norris, all of them, they're doing the right thing for us, and they've just opened the future up for martial arts, whether it be wrestling, boxing, judo, karate, any type of martial art. You can call football a martial art if you like, because it's all tied up within the same thing. But yeah, they opened it up for us from the 1970s. It's just been booming since then. Once it hit the movie screens and the TV, my club's just boomed as well. And any other particular club, especially the Kung Fu side of things.
The glamour images of Hollywood, though unrealistic, have helped popularise martial arts. The predatory nature of our society has done the rest. But for people like Tony Renata, it's more than a passing fad. It's an all-consuming passion he prefers not to imagine being without.
I could go back to concreting, but that's too much on my back, But I have got another trade that I can go back to, but it's just as hard as well, so I think I'd much rather stick on the martial arts side of things. I've put too much work and effort into what I'm doing to let everything go downhill,
I was standing in line with Mr. Jimmy. A man, did he look pretty easy?